Did you miss me?
Of course.
Hi.
Hi.
Tell the people how great I am all the time.
One of the most fantastic ladies I know that come to our building and charm it.
I feel like you're not telling the truth. Are you putting it on for the camera?
No. Me lie?
The purpose of this video is because I want to show you guys like some options in the Upper West Side. Like I was just talking to Vinny before the camera. I work with a lot of students in the Columbia area, and this is like the hot spot for that because you can just walk to and from school. Like people don't want to get on a train. So I roped Vinny in to show us some studios that are available. So how many we have?
I can show you two small studios, a large studio, and a one bed.
First thing, walking into the door, you have the bathroom on the left. And then we go to the right and we have a closet, a full-size closet. Put storage at the top. And then coming into the main space. So it's good that that has a bed right there because you can kind of tell how big the space is. So we've got two chairs here. There's some stuff that's moving out of here. So this is a twin single bed. So you see you can fit a desk or a small chair over there and a small dining table if you want. And it's pretty cloudy out today, so it's hard to see, but there's usually sun pouring in. We're facing north, but we're really, really high, so you get a lot of sun. And then once you turn around, you see the kitchen. So it's a full-size refrigerator, a full-size stove oven, and then you're back to the entryway. A rough estimate came out to 10.5 by 14, so we're looking at around 147 square feet for the main space, not including the bathroom and the closets. So about 150 square feet of living space, including the kitchen. After some basic measurements of kind of like the bathroom and the hallway, that's looking about another 50 square feet. So altogether, we're at about 200 square feet for this entire apartment. Walking into the second unit, and this is another small studio. To the left again is the bathroom. So this one is a brown tile, and then they are completely refurnishing it. So it's painted. Anything that needs to be fixed gets fixed. So we were just talking about how there's a smaller refrigerator, not like the super, super tiny ones, but a smaller one. But I think they could probably take out that cabinet there and get a tall, slim refrigerator. So that's a possibility, or put some cabinets on this side here. So I like this studio because it's the only line in the building that has two windows, which in a small studio like this is very hard to come by. This bed is a full-size bed, so you can see how much space you have after you've got the bed in there. So it's definitely enough to fit other furniture, probably just a desk and then some kind of wardrobe situation. This looks like that IKEA glass cabinet that a lot of people have. So you can tell how big that is and how much space is left over. Sorry. And then here is the closet. And it's a standard size closet again. If I had to live in a small space, this would probably be the one I would do just because it has so many windows. So you get so much light in the space and it just kind of feels bigger. All right, I'm out of your way. Thank you. So we are in a large studio, and when you walk in, you have a separate kitchen as opposed to the kitchen that's in the space in the other ones. And then this is going to be the one with the carpet. So when you walk in, the carpet kind of starts at the hallway. And this one has the new bathroom. The larger studios have more closet space. That's one closet and two closets. And then you walk down a little corridor. And then this is the larger studio. And so it's about 1.5 times the space. This is your view. And all the apartments in this building have good views, so that's never an issue. And then we turn around. There are no lights on, so you can see how bright it is now. For most people I put in the large studios, they could fit a queen size bed, a desk, a dresser, but a lot of people put their dressers inside of the closet so you don't take up space. Before we talk about the price, let's also remember again, like I always tell you guys, this is New York. We're in the Upper West Side. We have a doorman, multiple doormen. We have an elevator, we have laundry, and we have a roof deck.
With the larger studio, all our apartments actually, water, electric, and gas are included.
So utilities are included, because a lot of people ask
utilities
about
that. Utilities are included.
Okay, what's the price on this studio, this large studio?
$2,450 is the going rate for this size studio.
And all utilities included, and then for the small studios there, how much?
$2,150.
Like I said, from a lot of people who don't live in New York, that is a sticker shock, but for people who live in New York, it's like, it's not a bad deal. Okay guys, so because this is an empty apartment, and I work in this building a lot, Vinny has left and give me some time just to get some shots of this room. Since there's some furniture in here and most places I get to see are empty, I'm gonna have a little fun and rearrange some of the little bit of furniture that's in here. I know tons of people in my videos, they say, you know, once you go into a small space, you have to loft the bed, but I go into spaces as if I would live there, and I personally would not live in a loft bed. So I always will try to put a bed on the floor. And so I'm just going to see how I can arrange the furniture and then get a shot of that so you can kind of see the scale of what would go where. Rearrange things, and I'm gonna show you guys what I would do in my situation if I had a studio like this. And I have specifically thought about moving to this building when I thought I was going to move. So I've had this kind of layout in my head for quite some time, but I want to hear in the comments below what you guys think and how you would lay out the space. So let me show you kind of what my idea was. I am a grown woman, so I need a queen size bed. So I measured that the queen size bed, the width and the length would come out to about here. So this is where it would end, and you would still have enough space to walk down the hallway and you wouldn't bump into the bed. And then if you needed a nightstand, this is not necessary because you can mount something onto the wall, but if you wanted a nightstand on the floor, then obviously the nightstand would go next to the bed. And then I can't live anywhere without a couch, so I put the table and the chair there, which would simulate a two-seater couch, I believe. And I'm not a coffee table person, but if you wanted a coffee table, that would kind of be like the perfect size. So that was already there. Now this, I was a little difficult for me because I absolutely need a desk and I need a place to eat. So I was thinking a desk could go next to the couch because that's kind of the way I have it set up in my house now. A small desk here could fit with a chair and a small round table here with two chairs. And I was going back and forth to see if once you put a table here, like, could you still walk past this to get to the desk? And I think you could. And even if that wasn't an option, you have the space here where you could possibly put your desk. So for sure, everything can fit into this space. So I did a ballpark measurement with my size 11 feet. That's the best I'm going to get without an actual tape measure. And this main living space is 11 by 17, so we're looking at
187 square feet, give or take. And then I just did a basic measurement of like the bathroom, the kitchen, and the hallway with closets. And that's about 120 square feet. We're looking at just over 300 square feet. For studios in New York, that's actually pretty average. So just wanted to give you guys those details. Now let's head up to the roof deck. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the tiny apartment tours in this building. Let me know down below what you guys want to see, and I will talk to you guys in my next one.